Hey guys, Jim Halterman from TV Guide Magazine and TV Insider. I'm here with Bradley Gibson, who plays Tyler Robinson on the hot Netflix show Partner Track.
So tell me, what would be your solution to this pesky problem?
Acquire him.
Eat him.
Well, more like hire him.
So he will belong to me.
He'll be a lot less inclined to shit talk you online. Make him an offer he can't refuse. Hire us. We have one of the most robust M&A departments in the world. We can guide you through it and then be there on the other side for all your other legal needs and definitely increase your brand's online performance. I have some ideas.
I like this plan.
Great.
Bradley, so good to talk to you. I was a quick fan of the show, as you know, and I love Tyler in the show. Tell me the time right before the show dropped and then drops. How do those two times compare? Once people start watching and social media blows up, what is that like?
Oh my gosh. First of all, thank you for having me. And it was crazy. Before it dropped, you know, we were kind of living in kind of limbo, you know? You make this show with a small group of people and it's kind of like your baby, right? No one knows what we did except for the people that are a part of the production. And you just wonder, you know, I've seen it. My castmates have seen it, showrunners, producers have seen it, and we all love it and all get, you know, lost in the escape of it. And you just hope people feel the same way. And I was actually on a flight coming back from San Francisco the day that it dropped. And I had told myself that I wasn't going to get on Wi-Fi and check Twitter, see what's going on. But I did because, you know, that's what I did. And I started seeing people tapping into the show from, you know, different points in the world. And it was just, you know, it was excitement and people were getting lost in it. People were having, you know, really strong feelings about the relationships and the clothes. And it was so cool. It's been the coolest experience.
I love it. Well, once I watched the whole season, you get this early on, but I think even more as you get into the later episodes, you really see the core friendship between Tyler, Ingrid, and Rachel, and just how that's kind of the core of the whole show. How was that for you guys filming? Did that kind of translate with Arden and Alexandra?
Yeah. Ooh, that was my biggest fear going into filming the show, because we didn't have any, you know, crazy chemistry test or screen test. And I didn't know. I was like, you know, are these girls going to like me? Will I like them? Will we work well off of each other? But the second we met, it was like kismet. And as the production progressed, you know, we became more and more connected. Our friendship bonded. You know, people on set called us Destiny's Child, our text group, the Destiny's Child text group.
And I love that.
Conversation, whether it be about the show, whether it be about, you know, things that we like or TV shows we're watching or music or clothes or whatever. They truly are, you know, two of my best girlfriends now. And I think that because of that relationship and connection that we have, that's why you can feel it from on screen. Yeah. It's really real. I love them. I have such respect for them and for the work they did in the show and how they show up as people. I love those girls.
Speaking of the clothes, obviously everything Tyler wore was amazing, whether it was just like casual wear and like a robe, or he was like dressed to the nines for an event. What was a day like for you when you got to go to some of those fittings and you actually got to see what they were going to put him in?
You know, I am an actor that definitely works from the outside in. I've always been that way with my stage work, on screen. And I knew going into this, I was like, you know, how am I going to feel like this lawyer, this boss lawyer who, you know, takes no victims, who is strong, who also has this really strong love and appreciation for fashion, the fashion industry. And, you know, our costume designer and I would go in those fittings, those 4 or 5 hour fittings with tons of suits and shirts and ties and shoes and all the cufflinks and everything, and just really collaborated. And our costume designer, Jolie, had amazing ideas and pulled amazing things. And I think that the clothes just helped me tap into the character even more so, because while, you know, I love the clothes he wore, his taste and style is not my own. It's so fun to play like that, you know?
Sure. So I know official word has not come out yet on a season two, but what's your gut tell you? Because I know what my gut's telling me and what I need, but you tell me.
My gut tells me that we need season two. I can't wait to get back on set and to, you know, walk on the streets with Arden and Alex and play Ingrid, Rachel, and Tyler. I think it's
I love it.
I feel like we're forming like one of those, you know, iconic television friendships that I think is it's classic, but yet it's different because it's not the same, you know, the energies are different because we have an Asian woman, we have a white Jewish woman, we have a black queer man. that's a different trio. That's a different dynamic. And there's a lot of things we can play with. We have so many stories to tell. And I think we're also giving people an opportunity to feel seen. I feel like that friendship group is really allowing people to see themselves in a way that they haven't seen themselves on television. So we need season two.
All right, you guys, Partner Track is out on Netflix right now, season one. Go watch it now or go watch it again if you've already seen it. I think it deserves a second viewing. Bradley, thanks so much for your time, and I can't wait to talk about season two. My fingers are crossed for you.
Yes, thank you for having me.